Hello students, I'm Dr. Himanshu Kanpal, Assistant Professor English, Government MS College for Women, Bikaner. In the previous videos, we have discussed the poem Rabbi Ben Ezra by Robert Browning till stanza 20. Now we are going to continue with stanza 21. The poem is in form of a dramatic monologue and it is written from the perspective of a historical figure, Rabbi Ben Ezra. We are going to start with the stanza 21. Be there for once and all, severed great minds from small, announced to each his station in the past. Was I the world arraigned, were they my soul disdained? Right, let it speak the truth and give us peace at last. The great Jewish scholar continues to emphasize the value and significance of the old age in this stanza. He says that with old age comes wisdom and discrimination, which enable the old men to judge and differentiate between what was foolish and what was wise, or what was low and what was high in his past life. Be there means in old age, for once and all. Severed means separated, great minds from small, announced to each his station in the past. To each should be assigned its proper place and value. Was I the world arraigned, were they my soul disdained? Arraigned means criticized, found fault with. Disclaimed means hated. So in old age he can correctly evaluate his own past actions as well as those of others. He can announce to each his station in the past. He can assign proper place and value to the actions of his own as well as of those of others, and assign to them their proper place and value. Now he can judge for himself whether the world who criticized him or he who looked down with contempt upon the world was right. Was I the world arraigned, criticized? Were they my soul disdained, mean hated? Right, let each speak the truth and give us peace at last. Speak the truth means pronounce correct judgment. Peace at last means old age is a period of calm and spiritual serenity when all doubts and uncertainties are set at rest. It is a period of reflection, not of action. When we are in old age, that we look at our past actions, whom we criticized and who hated us. He can now form comparative estimate of his own youthful struggles and aspirations, what he aspired in his youth, when he was young, and what troubles came in his way. Old age is not the period of struggle. It is a period of calm and quiet meditation and reflection. We move on to the stanza 22. Now, who shall arbitrate? 10 men love what I hate, shun what I follow, slight what I receive. 10 who in ears and eyes match me, we all surmise. They this thing and I that, whom shall my soul believe? He says that in this paragraph, Rabbi Ben Ezra says that opinions differ widely from person to person. Now, who shall arbitrate? Arbitrate means decide. 10 men love what I hate. What he hates, says the rabbi, is loved by many others. Who is going to decide in this condition? Shun what I follow, what he follows and accept is avoided and hated, disliked by others. Slight what I receive. Slight means hate. Men are alike as far as their physical self is concerned. All have similar eyes and ears and other bodily organs. Slight what I receive. 10. Who in ears and eyes, alike in physical self, match me, we all surmise. In this respect, all men are equals, but they differ widely in their conjunctures, views and opinions. Match me, we all surmise. We differ in views. They this thing and I that, whom shall my soul believe? Under the circumstances, it becomes difficult to decide which particular opinion is right and which is wrong. Man is bewildered and baffled with doubts and does not know what to accept as true and what to reject. Now we move on to stanza 23rd. Not on the vulgar mass called work must sentence pass. Things done that took the eye and had the prize, over which from the level stand the low world laid its hand, found straightway to its mind, could value in a trice. Now Rabbi Ben Ezra says that the worth of a man must not be judged by his gross material activity called work, not on the vulgar mass. Vulgar mass means gross material work or activity which is visible and tangible. Well, called work must sentence pass. Sentence pass means judge. Judgment should not be given on the basis of gross material activity. Such visible and tangible activity is easily noticed by the people and rewarded. Things done must sentence pass. Things done that took the eye and had the prize. Took the eye means easily noticed. Had the prize means were rewarded. They were easily noticed. Over which from the level stand the low world laid its hand. Such work stands on the same low level as the common people themselves, so they readily notice it. Over which from the level stand the low world laid its hand. Low people readily notice this, frowned straightway to its mind and could value in tries. Such work stands on the low level as the common people themselves, so they readily notice it, catch hold of it, accept it and at once assess its value and significance. What they do? The low people straightway find such gross work acceptable. It pleases them. Now we move on to the stanza 24. Here he continues the idea of the earlier stanza, but all the world's coarse thumb, the coarse and vulgar people of the world can only measure and assess the tangible and visible achievements of a man. The finger failed to plumb, so past in making up the main account, all instinct immature, all purposes unsure, that wait not as his work, yet swell the men's account. The writer says that, but all the world's coarse thumb, rough and ready methods of evaluation. The coarse and vulgar people of the world can only measure and assess the tangible and visible achievements of a man. The finger failed to plumb. Plumb means fathom. But these coarse and vulgar people, with their rough and ready method of estimating the worth of person, fail to fathom the hidden motives, impulses, and instinct which cause and inspire the outward action of men. The hidden motives which inspire outward action of men. All instinct, immature means undeveloped. All purposes unsure that weight not as his work, not valued as his work, yet swell the man's amount, increase his credit with God. God does not ignore him, that weight not as his work, yet sell the man's amount. They pass them over in the preoccupation with their material and gross work. Undeveloped instinct, doubt and uncertainties which trouble the soul are not considered by the world as of any worth at all. People pass judgment on the basis of the work done, but they do not look what troubles, what doubts and uncertainties which trouble the soul, what man has passed through in accomplishing that task. He has given his body and soul to the task. Low kind of people, they do not notice this and pass the judgment on the basis of the work that is clearly visible, not the amount of the labor that has gone unrecognized. So no importance is attached to them in this world, but such doubts and uncertainties, the hidden motives and impulses, are the real indications of the nobility and worth of the soul, that not weighed as work yet swell the men's amount. The world may not value them, but they are valued highly by the God. Were not valued by the world, swelled account. It means increase his credit, yet swell the men's account, increase his credit with God. God does not ignore what a person has passed through, as the other people pass the judgment on the basis of the work done. They do not look at the problems and the troubles faced by the soul, but God is someone who does not ignore them, and the person's credit, his hard work, is judged by God, and it increases his credit with God. Now we move on to the Stanza 25. Thoughts hardly to be packed into a narrow act, fancies that broke through language and escaped. All I could never be, all men ignored in me, this I was worth to God, whose wheel the picture shaped. Man has many ideas and ideals which cannot be transformed into action. It happens with every human being that we have many ideas and ideals in our heart, but they cannot be transformed. Thoughts hardly to be packed. To be packed means they are hardly to be transformed into action, into a narrow act. Fancies that broke through language and escaped. Often he has a sublime and lofty notions which cannot be expressed in words, and which are forgotten as soon as they arise in the mind. Man has many aspirations and ambitions, which, however, he fails to achieve. He fails to live up to his own ideals. Fancies that broke through language, aspirations, broke through language and escaped, failed to express. Such noble ideas and ideals are ignored by the vulgar and foolish people of the world. All I could never be, all men ignored in me. There were many kind of aspiration in the heart of a man, but he is not able to transform them into action. And these things are easily noticed by the foolish people, and they pass the judgment on the basis of this. But Rabbi Ben Ezra says that God judges the worth of a man by such unrealized ideas and ideals. This, I was worth to God, whose wheel the pitcher shaped. Here the poet compares human life and destiny to a pitcher and God to a potter, whose wheel the pitcher shaped. It is God who moulds. God is destined to a pitcher and God is a potter. It is God who moulds human destiny as a potter moulds a pitcher. As long as we are in the hands of God, He is going to shape our destiny. Hence, men should care for the judgment of God, not that of men. So, Rabbi Ben Ezra feels that as long as God is the potter and we are, and the human beings are the pitcher, as long as God is the potter, we should feel safe, as God is responsible for molding the human destiny. What we are going to face in our lives, the troubles, the things that we aspire for, God has planned for us. He is looking at our lives, and what we are doing, that should be recognized by God, whose hands men should, in the end, what a man should care, he should care for the judgment of God and not that of a man. It means, like, I repeat the lines of the previous stanza, that he should increase his credit with God, not with that of man. Now we move on to the stanza 26. Note that potter's wheel, that metaphor, and feel why time spins fast, why passive lies are clay, thou to whom fools propound when the wine makes it round, since life fleets, all is changed, the past gone, cease today. The metaphor of the potter means God is, in the previous stanza, here the poet compares human life and destiny and God to a potter. This metaphor of God to a potter, the metaphor of the potter and his wheel used in the previous stanza is continued in this stanza. The great rabbi asks us to note the metaphor in which God is represented as the potter. Metaphor is an implied comparison between two things. Is represented as the potter. Time is represented as this revolving wheel and man's soul as passive clay. Then feel why time spins so fast, why passive lies are clay. The image of a potter wheel recurs frequently in the heavy from where he is taken. This image frequently reoccurs in the Bible. In this image, the potter is God, the wheel is time, and the pitcher is man. Passive here means why passive lies are clay. Passive means immovable and active and also helpless. So the great rabbi asks us to note the metaphor in which God is represented as the potter, time is represented as the revolving wheel, and man's soul as a passive clay. The pleasure seekers propound the doctrine in a different way. According to them, as the world is short-lived and transient, man should not engross his attention in future life and in another world, to whom fools propound. Fools means the pleasure seekers propound. Propound means they express negative kind of philosophy. Further, when the wine makes it round, since life fleets, all is changed, the past gone, cease today. Further, they are of the opinion that as time is fast passing away and the past cannot be recalled, so he should enjoy himself in the present. And Rabbi Ben Ezra, or we can say Browning, is not in favor of this kind of philosophy. He says that the philosophy of the pleasure seekers, they believe that future is nothing, next world is nothing, means whatever is today, and we should enjoy life at this very moment. But Rabbi Ben Ezra negates the thing. He says that the speaker regards such philosophy as propounded by fools. Okay, the reference here is to the view of the poets like Omar Khayyam. Browning is critical of such foolish philosophies. Philosophy as propounded by the fools for the benefit of other fools. We are going to stop here. In the next video, we are going to continue with the next stanzas and we'll finish the poem. Thank you.